we've always had virtual production dating way back in filmmaking, right? You know, translates or other types of rear projection that was on set and on stage. I think the Stage 15 volume wall takes that just another step further. When you can put an actor and a director and a DP in a situation that makes them feel like they're actually there, it's a game changer because it enables a further focus on creativity. It creates a more authentic performance and makes things that much more efficient.
Stage 15 is a window to the world. Our wall here we built was 80 feet in diameter, 26 feet tall. We were one of the first studios that built out our own volume wall. It's all encompassing. You can bring any environment here and shoot here locally and not have to travel through different parts of the world. But we really want to take new technology and be able to build it and offer it internally to our team.
It's a place where you can safely experiment. There are difficult and unsafe shooting scenarios and chase sequences and battle sequences and such that you can actually do very safely for crew and for cast in a virtual environment. So it became an opportunity of innovation.
The technology itself is groundbreaking. In this day and age, it really is all about interactive backgrounds that are photoreal and have parallax and act and work like real backgrounds. That's where the volume comes in, that you have depth and parallax when you move the camera around. So all this is done through an Unreal Engine game engine, and all the assets are built in Unreal. So we're able to project those on the wall and then be able to move our assets around, be it CG characters or props like a flashlight or anything else. It all work within that CG environment and be real time.
What you see here at Stage 15 isn't just technology, it's also production workflow.
The cloud is what's powering this stage right now. So our infrastructure for compute and storage of the data is what's behind all of this.
So the idea of having camera to cloud, all that footage is being sent right to the cloud, right to the editorial bay, and the editor's cutting it and starting to work with it. It's a way to really have real-time responses to what you're shooting, to know that you're getting what you need to, and you're also able to kind of change the plan a little bit and make things a little more innovative if you want to based on what you're seeing. So AWS has multiple touch points within our workflow that help us be more efficient.
And I think that each step in production along the way, both on screen and in the back room of development and coding, you know, there's an application for generative AI. And if it can help save 10 to 20% of the time that it normally takes in some very mundane tasks, for example, well, that lets you, again, iterate on the creative aspect of what you're doing.
And that's what technology is. It's a device to be able to tell the story. Directors come in and say, can we do this? Could we do that? And we're starting to have less compromise and get more epic, more big.
We're talking about being in the era of endless possibilities. If you can think it, we can make it happen.